A long relationship with Christina Aguilera as a friend, and she was a real champion of my product, and she was buying lots and lots of it. And when she was getting married, I made her engagement rings and wedding rings, and then we were really drunk one night. She's very small one night. I hit her really hard. She woke up in the morning and she was the face of my brand. That's so not true. We were drunk, but anyway, she agreed to be the face of my brand. And if we stop on this one for a minute, I'd not really ever had. I'd certainly never had a face of a brand, but someone that's really famous is really quite extraordinary, because in England, people would go to me, Christina Aguilera, come on, she's like a pop star, what do you do? But what they really don't know, honestly, because we think very narrowly in this country, is if you go to Russia, they just couldn't believe it. They loved it. I mean, and even in America, I mean, she did a gig for me once for just Stephen Webster in Las Vegas, where I could just invite my clients. I mean, my God, can you imagine? It was like 300 people, just her, on stage for us. She would normally have been playing stadiums, you know, with 10,000 people. It was really magic for our brand. Drew a lot of attention to us. And this particular image was, you know, people would say to you, you know, you spend a lot of money on advertising, all brands, and, you know, does it pay off? Well, I think a lot of it is really about that sort of, you know, you just get out there. People sort of, they get used, familiar with the brand. They know what the brand does. But with this particular ad, this one, these two pieces just became a massive hit. And we still sort of go back to this to go, you know, what was it about that? And I think I've had a lot of people look at it. You know, that ring is a crab, right? Now, I'll tell you what, when you're designing things, you never think your biggest selling ring is going to be a crab. Right? You think it's going to be around the edges somewhere. But this became our biggest selling ring. It wasn't just for 1 year. It was like for about 3 years. And it really became this sort of must-have. Extraordinary. It's a crab. And it's expensive. It's like £8,000 or £9,000. But it sort of started with this image, because we had the crab already. We already had crabs. and then we did this image. So it was a year later, and that's when it became the biggest selling one. And then it just sort of went on and on. And it still is. It's still be right up there. And I think the number one's a lobster now. The second's, you think I'm joking? I'm not. And the second one's a crab. So anyway, that was sort of the power of that. And you know, we sort of went on, and I've just got a couple of people. There's the crab. Yeah, there was a little cartoon at the beginning. I mean, it's a beautiful crab. There's lots of events and stuff with Christina. And then this is my store I just opened in Beverly Hills. And we can go on to one more. It's got a beautiful store, and I've had some of my artist friends have done things on the inside. Because when I first opened my first store, I didn't really think about it. It was just a jewellery shop. And now, I've been very lucky that I sort of can play around with it a little bit, and I wanted to. It's a bit like showing the film at the beginning. I've got a lot of things.